Hey everybody! Really glad to see you all again. Yes, today we will access whatever we studied in Chapter 1, Earth in the Solar System. So, let's see what all we know by reading it fill in the blanks. First filling the blank, asteroids are also known as planetoids. Next, Neil Armstrong landed on the moon in the year 1969, that means almost 50 years ago. Next, the planet which has a red spot is Jupiter. So Jupiter has red spot on it. Next, the outer planets are also known as Jovian planets. The Jovian planets are Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus and Neptune. True, false. First one, millions of stars together form the solar system? No. Millions of stars together, they form galaxies, not solar system. So this one is false. Next, Jupiter has several rings. False. Because Jupiter has red spot in it, while Saturn has several rings. Next, the Earth is called the blue planet. True, it is only the Earth which has life and it is also known as blue planet. Next, Venus is called the evening star when it is seen in the western sky after sunset. This is true. Venus is called morning star when it appears in the east before sunrise. Also, it is known as evening star when it is seen in the western sky after sunset. Next, the distance traveled by sunlight in a year is called a solar year. No, false. The distance traveled by light in a year is called a light year. Now, let's define few terms. Star. So, stars which we see at the night in the sky, they are the twinkling spots of lights. Stars are self-luminous celestial bodies made of very hot gaseous matter, and these stars also emit heat and light. Solar system. The sun and the objects like the planets, their satellite, asteroids, comets and meteors that move around the sun together form the solar system. Planet. Planet is a part of the solar system. Planet is a non-luminous celestial body that orbits a star. Planets reflect the light of the sun that falls on it. Planets do not have their own light. Asteroids. Asteroids are celestial bodies that revolve around the sun between the orbits of Mars and Jupiter. Asteroids are also known as planetoids. Meteors. Meteors are solid rock masses moving at tremendous speeds around the sun. Now, let's answer few questions as well. First one is, why do stars differ from planets? So let's differentiate stars from the planets. Stars are self-luminous, while planets are non-luminous. Stars, they emit their own light and heat, while planets reflect the light of their star, for example, sun. Stars are very hot, while the temperature of the planet depends on the distance from the star. Stars twinkle. Planets do not twinkle. Stars are very large. Planets are smaller than the stars. The sun is an example of a star, while the earth is an example of a planet. Next one, what makes the earth a unique planet? So, the earth is a unique planet because of the following reasons. Number one, it is the only planet where life has been found. Earth is at optimum distance from the sun. It has an average surface temperature of 14 degrees Celsius. Earth has suitable seasons and weather conditions for living. Earth also has adequate availability of fresh water. Earth has a presence of an atmosphere that protects all the living things from the harmful ultraviolet radiations from the sun. Next, what are constellations? Name any two of them. So, what are constellations? The stars in the sky appear to be arranged in recognizable patterns which are known as constellations. Some constellations look like people, some like animals, while some look like certain objects. Two such constellations are Ursa Major and Orion. You need to also draw the diagram of Ursa Major and Orion, which is also given in your books. Next, list the planets in the order of their distance from the sun. Very easy. My very educated mother just served us noodles. Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune. Next, what are the different phases of the moon? The major phases of the moon are the new moon, also known as Amavasya, the first quarter, the full moon, also known as Purnima, and the last quarter. We also need to draw the diagram which is shown on the screen. You can also take the help of your books. Next, why do we get to see only one side of the moon from the Earth? So, the time taken for the revolution of the moon around the Earth is 27 days and 8 hours. Since the time taken for the moon to rotate is also the same, we always see the same side of the moon. This was all for today's video. Feel free to ask your queries in the comment section. Happy learning!